Alrighty, well, good morning, everybody. Well, gonna try something different other than the usual pinball. I'm gonna go ahead and, and also, like usual, I'm in the middle of setting up, so. A lot of work. This is gonna be the second time I tried playing this game. So I don't. I'm still testing this out. And, yeah, so. Last time I tried testing this, I only checked to see whether or not this game was actually streamable. And as you can see here, it is. One thing I did notice about this game, that the majority of the stuff I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be using the mouse or I'm using the keyboard more. So if the music and sound is too loud, let me know. There's gonna be a certain way I'm gonna play this. In this game here, evasion affects the character's chance of evading physical attacks. The damage from the evaded attack is completely negated. So what this means is, the first two slots here, they're gonna be the front row. They're gonna be the front row guys. And due to the way evasion works on this game, unlike Final Fantasy XIV, you completely negate physical damage. Whereas in Final Fantasy XIV, it just reduces that damage by 20%. So what this means is that evasion becomes a much more appealable option. Yes, like usual, I'll be eating cinnamon rolls throughout the stream. No way, Jose, on food consumption. pride is keeping that human. Dexterity covers accuracy and evasion, so this is probably what I'll be loading up on. Probably the way I'm gonna do this, my front two guys. I go with dexterity and vitality. Back roll. I'll probably have one mage and one I think it's gonna be three rogues and one mage. Gotta get some accuracy in there, because on my first playthrough, I was missing constantly, so I gotta be able to hit. And I guess, if only to make it one less thing I gotta worry about, I'll just pump them all into unarmed combat. For traits? I'll probably make healthy one of them. And agile. Open up. I'm sure this music's gonna get pretty damn repetitious too. Probably the same thing here. Help stealthy, agile. And then the back row guys, I'll definitely have one mage. Insectoid mage. Give him the Manus look. And same thing here. Change that. Ugh, they eat more food. I like that though. They don't require as much food. Now, I'm not sure if spells can miss or not. To be on the safe side, and then the way this one works, I don't know much about the spells, but spellcraft, you wanna. I think you need your spellcraft to be at least 5, because I need to be able to cast the light spell. Because torches aren't exactly infinite in the dungeon, and I only made it to the second level, and I knew that one immediately. Again, I know very little about these spells, so he's not in the front row, so he ain't gonna need a staff defense. Oh, and if this is anything like Dungeon Master, You're not gonna need to find the scroll, you just need to know the spell immediately. You just need to know what runes to cast. As far as what element, I really don't know. You get on my first playthrough, you get a fire magic almost immediately. It's the first spell you get, because the fire blast thingy is the cheapest. So because of that, I'll go ahead and pick fire magic. Again, he's a mage, not a warrior. He's not tanking, so he doesn't need that one. Oh, Mistfighter. I need to change this. Same with this guy. Besides, it's only a plus two bonus to dexterity, so. Mainly because if I was constantly casting spells with him, I'd probably use it, but I'll just go ahead and do that. Because I can't, you know, only because I can't think of anything else to put in there. And I said I was gonna make this here is gonna be another rogue. Strength, mainly because she's probably gonna be my load bearing character, which, not trying to be sexist, but women don't strike me as a piece of burden, so I'm going to switch over to the guy. Probably throwing weapons, since start it up. So the storyline here is a bit like Path of Exiles as well. You're a prisoner being punished. In Path of Exile, you get chucked on the beach on a deserted island. This here's a variation of that. You just get dropped down into a dungeon. Thank you. One thing I definitely need to do. Gotta slide everything over on the left side this time. That I'm aware of, you can't move windows around in this game, so what you see is what you get. Hi, Katara. And yeah, I decided to go ahead and play this game instead. But, if you've ever played a game called Dungeon Master for the Super Nintendo, that's what this game here is based on. Also, if you would please, let me know if the music and or sound effects are too loud or too quiet for you. I have no way of knowing since my earphones are always at the same sound level no matter what. That's exactly where I got this, too. Alright, I'm checking my OBS right now. It looks like I do need to move everything down a little bit. And I'll just leave this here. Since, these front guys aren't going to be using any weapons. And before I throw that over there. My front two guys on the front row, they specialize in unarmed fighting, so they're not going to have any weapons in here at all. My third guy is a mage. And now that I think about it, let me see if I can drop this. I think the runes are this and this. Blink. Light spell. That means I don't have to carry torches around. And one other little quirk about this game. You're gonna find pressure plates, and more often than not, you have to throw something heavy on top of them. Remember this one. I had to actually go on Google in order to find it. There it is. Right, let me see what was back here. Man, this could almost be a DOS game. The way you have to move around. Oh, first ever monster. And another feature. And another feature that I've never seen in any other game. Food meter. A game called Dungeon Master for the Super Nintendo also had this as well, but they also had a water meter as well. So you could also get thirsty in that game. And no one's gonna get a knife. Unless you can throw these. Nope. And there is a map option with this game as well. Although there's actually an option to turn it off too. Which, Maybe if I had some more playthroughs under my belt when I know this entire game by the back of my hand, I'd probably turn it on, but otherwise, nope. Okay, I'm gonna have to wait for him to level up, so... Can't equip that. Okay, and this one here. I gotta find a little rock someplace. Or... Maybe that dagger I left might work. I think I left it over here. Go. Oh, and there's a... I don't think you get any XP for doing this. But, go back here real quick. Uh-oh. Okay, whew. I thought the game was gonna crash. Okay, so you still got it. Oh, evasion? I'm actually gonna give that to one of the tanks. He's gonna need it more on Mr. Backroll there. I guess one other drawback to this game is, unlike Dungeon Master, this game here uses the standard leveling up, you know, XP and all that, whereas with Dungeon Master, you actually gain levels by simply using the ability. Personally, I like that system more than I do this one. Which means I'm gonna have to level my mage up one in order for him to use it. God, did I screw that up? Gonna be a short game. Yeah, kind of overshot it. I don't remember what you did. I don't remember what you had to do this. There we go. Okay, I remember this. You gotta find two of these and put them in his eye sockets. This is gonna be an issue. Ideally, you want the combat to be out here in these wide open areas. I'm fucked. Well, at least he automatically picks up his, throwing items. There's the other one. And ideally, I will be doing this a lot. Like, not even fighting him head on. But I'm pretty sure in these higher levels, it's gonna be mandatory that I fight them like that. Ah, I remember this guy. Nice shot. I guess if only to give the mage something to do, I'll give him a pole arm. One big drawback to this game, you can't save just anywhere at any time and at will. You can only save at these crystals, so. And on top of that, it's on a cool. This crystal is on a cooldown. You can't just keep saving over and over and over. You have to wait till some odd amount of time has passed before you can use it again. And we'll be able to use that. Next level. Alright, two of my guys leveled up. Sure I didn't miss anything. I remember this right. You're gonna encounter your first missile chucker in this game, in this level here. Oh, there he is. And because I'm a moron, I just trapped myself. One wasn't enough. And they're fast, too. I don't think anybody can use that. Excuse me. It's actually perfect for him. Jerky. Mmm, yummy. And oh. And let there be light. I'm guessing I gotta put a torch in there. Solace. Let's run back and find one. Okay, so this is heavy armor. The way armor works in this game, I think there's light, medium, and heavy. If you're wearing armor that's too heavy for you, it actually lowers your evasion and all that. Yep, so I have no use for it. Okay, I need a key for this. Looks like we got an issue. Unless there's a key over here that I'm missing. Otherwise, I might have to do a Google search. Dagger, can't use it. An And, out of fear of my game crashing, I'm gonna run all the way back to first level and save. Like I said a few minutes ago, or excuse me, like I said some while ago, you can't save at will in this game. Okay, so going on the browser here. And let's hope my computer doesn't restart. Gotta love it. Gotta do some kind of obscure shit that I never would have known otherwise had I not have gone on here. Backtrack to where? Gotta love it. It seems like having a browser handy is pretty much a requirement for these puzzles. I mean, nowhere in there did it say, hey, look under some clothing, you never know. Hey, what's that piece of clothing sticking out from underneath the cell door? Gotta wonder what that is. No hints at all. I think before long, I'm going to be sounding like angry video game nerd here. A bow and arrow? Is a missile weapon. And he specializes in thrown weapons, so can't use it. So I guess I gotta... I guess I need another one. Can I open the door? Good thing I put some points of vitality, I'd probably be dead right now. Darn!
Rise from your grave.
I think I put points in evasion. Hey, note to self, don't set that off. Probably have to grossly outgear the area first. Oh yeah, I saw a little bit of it. It actually looked pretty cool. Pretty neat concept, actually. A D&D game show? Okay, I already know what one of the spells are, that one. Okay, that's Fire Burst. And then our, alright, I'm gonna look this spell up. Before I do that, I'm gonna have to, come on. I have to flip the light back on. Okay. I should have had enough to be able to cast an ice spell. Yeah. Not enough energy. I'd like there to be a key in here. Oh, are you kidding me? And I know what's up ahead. Let's see, where do I have to fight like four knights? course, there isn't anything on the ground. So what I'm going to have to do now is I'm going to have to run all the way back. I have to run all the way back and save. I guess I could find out what the screen missed is. So, this passageway here is basically absolutely nothing unless, well, it's a button. Oh, I think I remember this. This is on Dungeon Master, too. There's a bag. Or a knight. That to him just to give him something to swing with. So I basically got to keep teleporting this bag around until it pops up in the middle of the hallway. There we go. Red. No, don't want to go in there just yet. Okay, now I'll go back and do that fight.
Okay. fucked up. Cause I'm a retard.
Time for that to happen. And he'll wear that too. Bone amulet, not sure what that does. Shards, I already know what that does. Oop. Not where I want to go. And save there again. I would probably also say one other thing that could be a really good addition to this game is getting some kind of music going. It's like the only time they play music now is just during the main menu. I mean, I don't want to play my vinyl records because I already do that for Final Fantasy XIV. I sure as hell don't want to burn myself out on those. Oh, that's a whole line. Did not know that. Oh, that looks cool as hell. Is that an active skill, or do I have to equip it, or? Hello, son. Well, welcome to the stream. Just playing me some Legend of Grimrock. This is, basically, this is gonna be my, second time playing this. Last time I played this, I got as far as, pretty much the start of the second level. This time around, I'm probably about, let me find a good spot for this. I'm probably about halfway on the second level. I don't know how many total levels there are, though. This game here is a variation on what's probably my all-time favorite Super Nintendo game, Dungeon Master. So here, I go ahead and give 99 levels, huh? I guess I got a long ways to go. Yeah, I played the crap out of that one. Oh, okay. I don't... 99 levels wouldn't have surprised me. I played a Diablo clone called Fate. It was infinite levels, so you can You could go down as far as you wanted. Yeah, well, like I said, it's basically a Diablo clone. Made easier by cheats, of course. I wasn't saying you're wrong. I didn't recall him being made by the same company. Just repulses you back. Need a key for that. Which I don't have. I'm about to go ahead and save while I'm here. Okay, back on the browser. Okay. The Fate team was bought out by Blizzard Nor. Make a multiplayer version of Mythos, but say I never heard of that one. Thing I could think of on this. Guess they're really taking their time with that one, huh? 10 years? Yeah, I would think so. Yeah, 10 years would be a pretty long time for something to be in production. Hand axe. My front two guys are unarmed fighters. This guy here is a mage, and he's a throwing weapon specialist, so got no use for that. Speaking of that. Is that? Oh, wow, okay. Yeah, Joe's. Brothers cartoon. Yeah. Isn't, I think it's the same cartoon where he had that gangster guy. I'm a rabiat, you see? Rabiat. He's like a racer man or something. He just uses his head to erase him. And I don't have any, Yeah, and I only have, I got another spellcraft spell. I didn't know that. And I only got 2 on magic just to be able to cast that because of how cheap it is. So yeah, I'll go back on the browser. What up? Oh, darkness. Okay. You gotta need that. And like usual, it doesn't explain a damn thing of what I'm supposed to do to get past the door. Oh. And that was completely on accident. If you're talking about this, wrong one. I can't use this because you need Earth Magic 7 in order to do it. And this is all I got right now. As far as what to spend my points on, I really don't know. Probably go with either fire or magic. And oh, this guy here is my thrown weapon specialist. Sure, go for it. Go back and save. Okay. Okay, but like I said, I knew with this one here, Spellcraft, you're supposed to get the light spell, so I'm not putting any more points in this one. Just enough to get a light spell, so I'm not having to run around carrying torches, because they don't last forever. As far as fire and ice, I knew my first playthrough, I only needed 2 points just for the fire burst. So that's just to get some kind of spell going. This one here was just curiosity. I think there's supposed to be a frozen effect with ice, so again, this is just to get something other than a fire spell. But the front two guys, this is what it's all going in unarmed. Okay, a low chance. Alright. Yeah, and I also noticed it up. It goes on a line, too. It's not just right in front of you. Oh, this guy. And I saw another one too. Oh no. I screwed. Trying to keep my maze protected. So I lost my front guy. Oh, I want to go there. I saw that one. Yeah, it was up here. I had actually considered this because of the way I play. Ideally, I try to attack guys from behind. So that was actually pretty tempting, but I've also been in situations like you just saw a few minutes ago, where I'm trapped in a corner, I got two guys beating on me. I figured if that's gonna happen, I'm pretty much done for. So I just went ahead and went with unarmed combat. But yeah, I saw that too. Melee weapons from the back row. The only thing I wasn't sure on is if being unarmed would also be considered a melee weapon. But I just figured common sense kind of kicked. Oh, hello. Oh, it does? Good to know. So that won't get me to another spell. That might. Oh, here, let me just go on the browser. I'll just look here. So the next ice spell would be an ice arrow, which None of my guys use ranged weapons, so... Yeah, same thing here. Enchanted fire arrow. Poison cloud. Then air magic would be shock. Okay, so looking at the wiki here, it looks like it's the same pattern for all the elements. The second spell you get enchants your arrows, but as I don't have any ranged attackers, there's not much point in having it or getting it. Yeah, it's not telling me how much energy Frostbolt costs, though. I guess, if only because Frostbolt... Yeah, let me come back here. Only because Frostbolt only requires two runes and Fireball requires three, so that means one less rune I gotta cast. I'll go with Ice. Like I said, since I don't have any ranged attackers, that spell is completely useless. Just something I gotta get on my way to the next one. Common herb. Tree snake. Okay, so this is an antidote. So I'm guessing this is basically a healing potion then. Oh, can't stack them. Oh, God. I'm guessing if I can find another torch and put it in there, it might open it.
Oh,
secret door. Hello. Maybe not. Heavy armor. Skull. I think I remember reading this a long time ago, too. Wish I can go to races, but I think it was the Minotaur. For every skull he carries, he like deals extra damage or something like that. I don't know if it has any other uses though, so just gonna hold on to that. And not sure how this works, but jab and I guess kick and then 3-point technique are, am I supposed to load these on a hot bar or do they do it automatically or not sure how that works. I want to try something. And I would also think, being unarmed, you only have to have one hand free, not both. At least that's what I'm guessing. Kind of a pointless room. Okay, he's got a key, so. this is it. Okay, maybe it was. Oh, goody, more knights. Oh, wow. That is definitely gonna be instant death. This ain't split. Did it. Uses up a bunch of energy. Hope that was the only one. Blast, one Tarbead. Okay, I see how that works. And again, I'm also guessing that as long as you have one hand free, you can still fight unarmed. I'm missing something. Oh, apparently. Okay, so there's the way down. Choose for that. Okay, I'm gonna try to find a save crystal first. Yeah, I don't want to step on that pressure plate. Unless you got a statue on that. You got a wall statue there with its mouth wide open. Keep thinking it's going to shoot a fireball at me and kill my entire party. I think I did that. All this. All right, we're on to level 3. Clue what to do here. The only other thing I can think of is head back upstairs and start grabbing torches, bringing them down here and putting them in the empty slots, but. Go back on the browser. Well, it does have something to do with the torches, but. Get it. It's telling me I gotta find three of them. So apparently, the only other thing I can think of is I'm gonna have to run back up. I'm gonna have to run back upstairs and grab a few more of them. Give it to him. Hope they don't have to be fully lit. No, it would have been nice if the game actually gave me a clue on what I'm supposed to be doing without me having to go on the damn browser and finding the answers. I mean, even with this, I'm only making a guess at it. I'll guess it was. Frostbomb. You're the magic guy, you hold on to it. Actually, he doesn't really have the room. Whoa! Oh, it was him. So, looks like we got an archer among us. Nope, I don't want to get surrounded. Okay, I guess you can't actually equip them then. Kinda dumb. One of these. I better take a torch just in case. Yummy. I'm guessing there's some kind of trick to close these pits. There. Actually, you know what? Since I'm at a good stopping point right now, and I'm already getting kind of burnt on this. Not permanently, just not really in the mood to play much more. Especially considering you can't save wherever you want. I'm gonna go ahead and switch games, and I'm gonna switch to a game that I've been playing a fair amount for the past few days called Gems of War. I'm gonna go ahead and fire that one up. I've never streamed it before. Just a little leery on it, but I figured, what the hell, why not? So let me go over here. And that's something else too, another drawback to this game. The only time you hear music is in the main menu, you don't hear it anywhere else. It's kind of nerve-wracking. It also means I might have to actually pull up my little boombox and maybe start playing some cassettes and CDs or something. That might be something I'll probably consider doing next time I play this. But like I said, I'm gonna switch over to Gems of War.